يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريحان. يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، يقول الله تعالى: إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله، يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها 4 حرم، ذلك الدين القيم، فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم. My dear respected brothers, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending as-salatu wa salam upon our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, "Oh, who you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اتقوا الله." We all have to take the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in the Quran, "Oh, who you believe," is calling us for everything that is benefiting us. When he said, "Oh, who you believe," the scholar, they said, we need to listen carefully. There is something Allah will command you, or it will be something Allah prohibiting you. My dear brothers, a year has passed. A new year has started. We are on 2 boats, day and night. Day starting, day finishes. And the night starts and night finishes. And our life is only 3. A day that passed yesterday, it is past, it's not going to come back till the day of judgment. Today we are in are in this day, we have the opportunity to do a good thing. If it's finished today, it's going to be past. And it's tomorrow. Tomorrow, it is secret. It is ghaib. We don't know. Are we going to reach tomorrow? Or we can't reach tomorrow? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. So this is signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Day and night is the signs of Allah. And also is the signs that we count our days, our years, our weeks. So one day we're going to departure from this life. But we need to think about, what have we done last year? And we are in the new year now. What are we going to do? We need to have a plan. Muharram is the first month of the calendar of Islamic calendar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it 12 months in the year. But 4 months are special months. One of them is Muharram. And Muharram is the best month to perform fasting, to do good action. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أفضل الصيام بعد رمضان شهر الله المحرم. The best fast after Ramadan is the month of Allah, Muharram. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attributed himself to this month, because this month is special. So my dear brothers, it is a new year start. It is the best month to perform fasting. So let's take this opportunity to do more fasting in these days. And in Muharram, there is a special day. It's called Ashura. Ashura, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam came to Medina, he saw the Jews fasting on the day of Ashura. So they were asked about this fasting. Why are you fasting this day? And they said, today it is a special day which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted victory to Musa and Bani Israel. So we fasting to celebrate this day. It is the victory day. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, نحن أولى بموسى منكم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, we have more right to Musa than you. So we are very close to Musa, because the Musa alayhi salam, the Prophet of Allah, he was a messenger and he was a Muslim. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in that day fasted, and he commanded people to fast. So this is a special day. Abu Qatada radiallahu anhu narrated, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam su'il an sawmi yawmi ashura faqala yukaffiru as-sanata al-madiya. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked about fasting the day of Ashura, and he replied, it expiated sins of previous year. So the whole year the sin will be removed for the minor sins if someone fasts the day of Ashura. It's the 10th of Muharram. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu an said, ما رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحرى صيام يوم فضله على غيره إلا هذا اليوم يوم عاشوراء وهذا الشهر يعني شهر رمضان. The Messenger of Allah, Ibn Abbas said, I never saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم seeking to fast a day given preference over another day except this day. And a month was the month of Ramadan. Even the Quraysh used to fast this day. Quraysh كان تصوم عاشوراء في الجاهلية. In the Jahiliyyah, the Quraysh used to fast this day. And the scholars, they agreed that fasting of day of Ashura is Sunnah. It's Sunnah to fast the day of Ashura. Inshallah, we're going to explain the second khutbah, how many days we should fast in Ashura. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد. الإمام النووي رحمه الله said, اتفق العلماء على أن صوم يوم عاشوراء سنة ليس بواجب. إمام النووي, he said, the majority of his scholars, they agreed that fasting the day of Ashura is a sunnah, is recommended. It is not obligation, it's not obligatory. Ibn Abbas reported, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fast Yom Ashura and he commanded people to fast. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, the Sahaba, today is Ashura, even the Jews, they fast as well. And also, it's a special day for them. Then the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, if I leave next year, inshallah, I will fast on the 9th and the 10th. To differ from the Jews. So Ibn Hajar rahimahullah said, fasting Ashura is three levels. The lower level is to fast only one day. It is on the 10th of Muharram. And the second level is to fast on the 9th and the 10th, 2 days. The 9th of Muharram and the 10th of Muharram. That is the second level, the above level. But the lower level is to fast only one day. And also, the higher level is to fast 3 days. On the 9th, the 10th and the 11th. That is the scholars, they recommended to fast on Muharram. And also, as you know, sometimes the month, they will be different sighting the moon. Some of the country they sight a day and another country they start another day, so it's going to be different days. So if you fast 3 days, then you will you will get to fast on the day of Ashura. So my dear brothers, it's recommended these 3 days to fast on the 9th and the 11th and on the 10th and the 11th. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there's another hadith also says, Sumu yawman qablahu wa yawman ba'dahu. Fast the day before Ashura and the day after. But this hadith is not a strong hadith, but the scholars, they said, to be a safe side, so just fast 3 days. But the recommended day and the day that you're going to get the reward is to fast on the 10th. At least we should fast that day, inshallah. And Allah will remove the sin of the past year. Lastly, my dear brothers, just to remind myself and you, this month is the month of also giving. Whenever you give sadaqah, and it's great reward you will find into your scales in the day of judgment. So I recommend you and I remind you to inshallah donate for the masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah in this great month. Ala wa sallu wa sallimu ala Muhammadin kama أمر الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم اغفر لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار والحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.
خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريحان يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان.